If any content creator want to take on this challenge of creating a PvP world only hardcore Iron Man, you have my full blessing. But just know, I'm gonna do everything in my power to hunt you down.
FTC engineer tempting us and my PvP experience killing 5,000 Chaos Elder Druids on my previous hardcore, I decided it is time to try out a little challenge. It is simple, I have 1 week to obtain a fire cape on a fresh hardcore Ironman playing only in PvP worlds. And I will put all of the progress in this video. And yes, this means I will be using a bank for the first time in 4 years. Let's see how this went down. That is the first 10,000 GP in my name. I'm going to invest all of that into runes. And my early game plan is different than any other account. I'm going to hit up the lava dragons to make some money and get some prayer and magic levels. But I can't forget about the witch's house quest. An easy quest for an instant 25 hit points. I don't think it's gonna save us at lava dragons, but it does feel really good to get that. And that is 5 thieving as well. I decided to get that on the way to lava dragons in Edgeville because there's not a single person here. Alright, here we go. Into the deep wilderness. Okay, there's no one. That's good. Okay, who's this? Did someone scout me in Edgeville? That is pretty scary. First lava dragon kill for 20 magic and 66 coins. I am mostly after the rune items because they sell for a lot of GP and law runes would be nice as well for early teleporting. Most items I will get are probably worth some money early on. A second kill for a looting bag. That's going to be very useful actually. Okay, that is the first person. I think I was pretty fast on that one. I don't know if I got scouted in Edgeville earlier, but I've been killing these for 14 minutes. I used up all my runes, and one thing I like to do is running big bones from the boneyard to the chaos altar. It's a very easy way to get early prayer levels, and since I'm so early into the account, I don't have much to risk, so I would like to get at least 40 prayer, because I feel like there's gonna be more people using mage and range my level. So yeah, let's do a few of these bone runs. So I just finished my first trip and I got 18 prayer for my first run. That's pretty good, right? Another inventory done for 23 prayer. So since I didn't get too many good drops at Lava Dragons, I have a method to make money back. While doing this prayer method actually, every time I run back to the boneyard, I pick up these steel plate legs. And they sell for around 600 GP each, so that's around 2400 GP each inventory of bones. And I can put them in a loot bag, so that works out perfectly. Yes, I just got the item I wanted the most. 20 law runes. That is so big early on, guys. I can use it for basically escape teleports. I will get a bunch of magic levels from killing lava dragons. I want at least 40 for house teleports, so when I'm in a sketchy situation, I can teleport to my house and I will be completely safe. So that is an amazing drop. That drop will be a lot more useful than any rune item I can get. Woo, PKer. Haha, logged out. Thirty-seven prayer, beautiful. That's the first protection prayer. And there we go, selling my steel plate legs that I grabbed from the wilderness for a nice 15,000 GP. Oh, what? He locked in under me. 40 magic for home teleport. That is what I needed. I think that's gonna wrap up Lava Dragons for now. That is 40 prayer, the final level that I wanted. Let's get out of the wilderness and start some questing. There we go, Monk's Friend for 13 woodcutting and another 8 law runes for the stack. And there's Fight Arena as well for 29 attack and 17 thieving. That's Tree Gnome Village for 35 attack. Gonna do those quests for the early attack XP. And I actually really like this amulet. Gives some pretty decent defense bonus early on. And I can now travel to the Grand Tree and start my agility grind. That's 10 agility. I can now go to Draenor Village. my god, I am alive. Holy, he almost one-hit me. I freaking panicked. There he is. That must be the engineer. I do not want to go back there, so I got 20 agility in the gnome place. And you know what? If this video gets 10,000 likes, I will continue playing PvP Hardcore Iron Man and make more videos. Alright, I am going to kill some goblins. I don't think anyone is gonna guess this because normally you would do the waterfall quest for combat XP, but I'm going to skip this and instead kill goblins because I also want to get some more hit point levels and I can try some easy clue scrolls. So one tactic I use quite a bit is traveling in a free-to-play world and hopping to a member's world to do the action. I did this a lot for questing and things like clue scrolls. Got my first slave task on the way and it is goblins. That is perfect. First easy clue completed on the account for a Bandle's page and 6 Law Runes. That is decent. Law Runes are extremely good. I guess I mostly want purple sweets from these easy clues for fight caves because it is stackable food. Another easy clue completed. And there we go, that's the first 4 purple sweets. I love questing, but in a PvP world, it is a whole different level because all of these cutscenes, I think I'm just standing outside doing nothing and I can't do anything. Very risky. But that is the Restless Ghost completed. There we go, that's 20 strength at Goblin so far. Another easy clue completed for some goodies. I will look like an absolute snack in this. Alright, it is the next morning, so I'm going to do some more questing because the worlds are a lot more empty. And that is the Plague City quest completed. And the Biohazard quest completed. I need those quests later for the Ardy Cloak, so that's nice to get out of the way. Alright, that's the Rune Mysteries quest. And the Goblin Diplomacy quest. I'm kind of working towards a Bone Crossbow because I think that's the weapon I want to use for fight caves. It is pretty cheap to use, easy to get, and it will hit pretty decent. But before we can use that, we need to get some range levels. And again, I could do the Shadow of the Storm quest, but that is kind of risky. So I'm just going to train range from scratch and get myself level 28 for the Bone Crossbow requirement. There we go, completed another clue for 9 Law Runes and 4 Purple Sweets. And we got a Bob shirt. I didn't feel like waiting, but I sold all my leftover Lava Dragon loot and I made 17,000 GP. I will use that GP to buy some bolts. So for this clue we need hand boots and I am able to get them, but it might take a while. I think I'm going to grind them out. This took way too long. I basically got the full set plus multiple pieces and I just could not get the boots, but there they are. I did manage to get some other good stuff though, like the rusty sword, so we can complete the Ardy Easy Diary. But yeah, let's go and do this clue scroll. Another easy clue. Look at all these items. The ancient page is pretty nice actually. Yo, that's my first amulet and we got 10 purple sweets. We have a total of 18 purple sweets now. That is amazing. There it finally is, 28 ranged. I can now use the bone crossbow. That's a massive upgrade because the bolts are really cheap as well. And I think I'm also going to move locations. And there we go. I decided to get 20 defense for studded. I can now use a studded body, so that will boost my range a little bit. And I guess my tank ability is a little bit better now. Before we go back into range training, I do want to complete some quests. And for one of the quests, I need 30 fire making. So I decided to get 30 fire making in this kind of secret spot. I don't think anyone will ever look for me here. And yeah, that's the sea slug completed for an instant 24 fishing. Alright, so it's time to complete the Lost Tribe quest. I'm kind of terrified doing this quest because I have to go through Lumbridge a lot and there's a lot of people there and a lot of scouts, so it is potentially dangerous. But what I'm doing again is switching from free to play to members and traveling in a free to play world, it's a lot harder to die. And then switch back to a members world to talk to the NPCs for the quest. I think that's my safest way. And there we go, that's the quest completed. I also got myself a Ring of Life and 22 mining. And I can now buy a bone crossbow and bone bolts. I'm basically going to spend all my GP on that. 3700 bone bolts, there we go. I'm going to hit up my secret spot. See you there. So here we are, the Moss Giant Island in Karamja. I used this on my Karamja account really early on. And I doubt I'll see anyone here. First milestone, 40 ranged. I have to do a bit more questing to enter the Champions Guild. And then I can buy the green dehide. And that's probably also going to be my armor for fight caves, I think. I don't think there's any easy way to get any better dehide. And yeah, that's my first big trip completed. I got 2 keys in total. That's Cook's assistant for 32 quest points. I can now enter the Champions Guild and buy the Green Deite upgrades. So let's go. I made just enough money at Moss Jones to buy these upgrades. Awesome. I completely forgot you can buy Quaves here, so guess I'll pick that up as well. It feels amazing getting my hit points levels up. The lower the chance to get one hitted. Logged in for 2 minutes and that's the first mossy key of the day. I'm gonna be AFKing for a very long time in this spot. I think it's a secret enough spot and a pretty unknown spot, I would say. These keys are going to be amazing. I'm going to kill the boss for money. So yeah, I can basically trade my range here. I can trade my prayer. I can get runes. Law runes are very important as well because I have to panic teleport a lot later on as well. And yeah, I'm gonna get these keys. Also some really good seeds that I can use for farming and get my herbal up later. So we can get prayer potions for the fire cape. Like basically, I'm just gonna AFK my range here for a long time. Get some hit points and range levels. That also makes me feel a lot safer. So this spot is actually pretty amazing. But I have to keep it a secret. I don't want anyone knowing that I'm here. So I have to be careful, but I'm going from Rimington to the Brimhaven dock. And then I just walk here. So usually I don't see anyone. Another mossy key. Oh my god, I almost got a back-to-back mossy key. Look at that. The luck is coming in, guys. Wow, that's gonna be so nice, man. I already have 5 keys. They have such amazing drops like noted limbred roots, strength potions, but also stuff like rune plate legs, 5 noted adamant plate bodies. So, wow, I'm really getting... I don't know, I feel like I'm getting really lucky, but it's gonna be so nice for the GP. I can't wait to kill these guys. Another range milestone. I've been here for a while. That's 50 ranged. Very nice. And we are 45 combat now. Okay, I just got a curve bone. That is really, really rare. But it's actually not too bad. Because I think you can trade them in for construction XP. So if I do continue on this account, I can trade them in later for a lot of construction XP. I just got a second curve bone. Holy... That is insane. This is still the same trip, I think. Wow. That is kind of amazing, to be honest. Because that is like... I have like 13,000 construction XP in my inventory right here. That is gonna help so much, this strategy. If I collect all the long bones and the curved bones. And I cash them all in at the same time. Another mossy key and third one of the trip. Little update on the stats there, we are almost 43 prayer from melee protect. 54 ranged, 46 hit points. Alright, decided to do this very scary quest, Priest in Peril. I want to do this because it gives some prayer XP, so it's pretty nice. But it's also one of the most scary quests in my opinion, because you need to run essence to the guy to finish the quest. So you can bring a lot of food. But yeah, if I do decide to go for the Ava's Accumulator, I also have to do this quest, so I might as well do it. I will decide later if I go for the accumulator or not. Again, I use the free-to-play trick. I basically walk to the gate in free-to-play and then I hop to Members World to do the rest of the quest. Alright, that's another inventory down. We need one more inventory left. And that is Sea Engineer lurking in Lumbridge. I know that's him because he changed his name on all of his accounts. But that means I have to be extra careful right now. Alright, that is the final essence to finish this quest. There we go. Priest in Peril completed. So the nice thing about this quest is I can save some time completing Druidic Ritual because I can already buy all the raw meat in Canifis. And I also got an apple pie, as you can see in my inventory, because I started the Nature Spirit quest and I can use that for the Knight Sword if I want to later on. So I guess I do save quite a bit of time. Back to some questing, there's Druidic Ritual to start Herblore. I think it's a good time. While working on the Jungle Potion quest, I decided to kill some Jogers to finish 43 Prayer. And that's 47 hit points as well. Jungle Potion completed for 9 Herblore. So in order to do the Grand Tree and get my agility up, I need 25 agility. I decided to get it at the Brimhaven Agility Arena because this is a lot safer. So yeah, I got that requirement out of the way as well. We need 10 Herblore for the Dixite quest to get some more Herblore levels, so let's do that. I had to go to the Varric Museum inside of the Dixite quest, so I decided to do this small thing as well for 10 Slayer and 9 Hunter. The Dixite completed for, I believe, 17 Herblore, there we go. I'm going to quest all of my early Herbo levels before I like actually start training it. It's not a bad idea to get some quests out of the way anyways. Grand 3 quest completed for 32 agility and 41 attack. I just found this 121 combat mining in a PvP world, and this is the most unknown place probably. I just looked around to see if I can do anything here, and I might train my mining in this spot because probably no one ever goes here. But I found this guy over here. 121 combat, pretty juicy. Want to get my farming levels up, so I decided to do some recipe for disaster questing. And that is the goblin one done for 13 farming, very nice. Got some AFKing time, so we are back in my spot, and that's 55 ranged. Guess what, it's early in the morning again, so it is time for some questing. That is the Black Knight Fortress and the Recruitment Drive quest. That is the quest I wanted to complete the most, because it gives Herblore XP, Prayer XP, and I get this helm. And I'm probably just going to stay 20 defense for the fight cave, so I can actually use this helm, because it gives some prayer bonus. Alright, this should be the last kill for 40 for prayer. The final level I'm going for Eagle Eye, so I can flick that in the fight caves. There we go, 40 for prayer. Alright, I think what I'm gonna do now, I want 60 range for the new max hit with the bone crossbow. That should be good. I think I can easily do fight cave with 20 defense, 60 ranged, and like 50 hit points. So we're gonna do a couple more quests that get me a bit of Herblore XP. I think Shades of Morton, and maybe the Clan of Corrent that gives another 1000 XP, I believe. And after that, I think I'm just gonna camp Kale's Druids for Herblore XP, get 37, and then plus one with Greenman Ale to make prayer potions. And I think I'm good to go after that. So, oh, and maybe do the Imp Catcher quest for the Amulet of Accuracy, and maybe do some woodcutting training and a bit of Slayer to get the Accumulator. But yeah, that's pretty much all I need, so it's time to use my keys before I do all of that, so I can get some money and invest all of that money into bone bolts. That way I make sure I have enough for the fight caves. I'm pretty excited to use some keys, so let's see what we get out of it. Alright, so that was absolutely amazing. I made 78,000 GP just low alking the drop. That should be more than enough. And I got 200 law runes, so I will never have any issues with teleporting. That helps the account so much early on, actually. So if I do decide to continue, I have plenty of escape teleports. There we go, that's 45 magic. Decided to use the runes from Bryo. And the reason I got this level is teleport to Camelot. It is basically a safe area, and it only requires 2 runes instead of 3 runes, so that saves me 1 inventory space. It is almost time to grind out my Herblore, but before I do that, I want to complete the Shades of Morton quest, and for that I need 20 crafting, so I decided to get that real quick with the chartership method. And there we go, that is the Shades of Morton quest completed for 23 Herblore. Now, I will mention, I did make a small exception for this quest. I did the temple part in the Shades of Morton world. Basically, when I got to that part of the quest, I hopped and completed that real quick and then hopped back to the PvP world. I don't think it's possible for me to do that part solo in a PvP world unless I bring like a bunch of alts, but that kind of defeats the point as well. So I think it's fair, and it only took like a minute, so invested all of my GP into the bone bolts, and we got over 8,000 bone bolts. I will be using those bolts for Kale's Druids and fight caves, and that should be more than enough. And look at my freaking gear, guys. This is pretty much going to be my gear for fight caves. I decided to just skip the accumulator. I'm going to get the Arty Cloak once I'm 30 Herblore, so I can use the XP lamp on Herblore, and I will upgrade my amulet to the Amulet of Accuracy later on. And maybe I will upgrade the shield as well, we'll see, but I look like an absolute unit. I am mostly killing the chaos druids in the Edgeville dungeon because I can use my loot bag and basically bring two inventories every trip. So that will be very nice. And there we go, 60 ranged at Chaos Druids. That is my goal level in ranged, although I will probably get one or two more levels while getting all of the herbs for the herblore level. But it's not really going to make a difference for the bone crossbow max hits. Alright, so my method for Marantils is killing unicorns. For my Theramin, I'm getting ashes because it gives the same XP as strength potions and it's a lot easier to get the secondaries. So I'm just doing some fire making in a free to play world and I'm collecting the ashes. And that is 28 herblore, slowly making some progress. And I'm buying my chocolate in the Grand Tree for my Highlander potions, and that is a PKer. This happens a lot, guys. Whenever I see someone I just insta-log, I don't even care what the combat level is, I am not gonna check it. I just insta-log out. Alright, this should be the last requirement for the Ardy cloak. I'm 30 urban now, so I can use the lamp, and I will use that cloak for the fight case because it gives a bit of prey bonus. And there is no one here, so we are all good. Let's get this cape. Claim this beautiful Ardy cloak, and I'm going to use this lamp, and it should give me an herblore level. There it is, 31 herblore, and a nice cape upgrade. I did that quest for farming XP earlier in the video for this reason. I am planting some herbs to speed up my herblore grind. It is kind of risky to do farming, but it saves me a lot of time. 62 range, that is the final level I will get at Chaos Roots. I'm almost done with collecting all the herbs. There we go. That took a lot longer than I expected. I did at least a full day of herblore. But it's all done now, I can make some prayer potions. That is pretty much the last thing I need. The nice thing about having a bank is I probably have the item somewhere in my bank. And in this case, I bought the Green Man Ales ages ago. So there we go, we are boosting to make some prayer potions. I think this is also better because if one of the people hunting me down checks my high score, they see my herblore level and maybe they think I can't make prayer potions yet. So that's perfect. Collected a full inventory of Snapegrass. That should be more than enough. And there we go. Prayer potions on the account. Beautiful. Made myself 19 full prayer potions. More than I ever need. All of the skill requirements out of the way. It's time to upgrade my last two gear pieces. The Amulet of Accuracy. And this is pretty much my final gear setup for the fight caves. I'm looking pretty juicy in this. And I looked at the wiki and these ogresses actually dropped a mithril kite shield. So I decided to pick that up as well for my final gear upgrade. So I worked towards this point for almost a week and we are ready to take on this challenge. The question is, can we do it with this inventory? I think this is enough. So let's see how this goes. There's the healer safe spot set up ready. Let's do this. There we go, that's the fight caves done. Let's get to safety real quick. And that's it. That's my challenge completed. We got the fire cape. That took nearly 4 hours, but it was really fun. Well, I guess the gear was good enough. I'm pretty happy about that. We have some supplies left as well, so yeah, that was pretty successful. Alright, let's check Hans for the challenge as well. Alright, so 6 days ago. That means I'm successful. You've spent 2 days and 5 hours in the world, so that's 53 hours played. Perfect. I definitely enjoyed the PvP hardcore Ironman experience. I could put a GP bounty on my head as well if you guys want me to continue. Let me know down below in the comments. This is completely different content from what I've uploaded before, so if you enjoyed this video, subscribe and drop me a like. It took a long time to make this video, so I would really appreciate that. And if you guys want to see more videos like this, you know what to do.